Hi everyone, I'm Wafa Lango and welcome you all in Grammar in Detail. We will be having the part number 2 of past continuous tense and we will be discussing the usages here. So let's begin the first usage. We use this tense for those actions which were in progress in past. Means those actions which were continued in past, now they are stopped or completed or not completed, that is now being stopped. Now I say I was helping my brother. That was the action which was continued for a particular time in past, but now it is stopped. He was preparing for the test. Next, we use this tense with adverbials. Now I told you what are the adverbials. Adverbials are the time which you are going to mention. I told you adverbials are of three types: time, place and manner. Definitely when we talk about adverbial time, so that comes in past, present or future. Here you will be using adverbials of past with all. You will be using your adverbials with all to emphasize, to stress upon the continuity of an action. You will be expressing the continuity of an action, that it was continued all the evening, all the day, etc. Now example, I was reading newspaper. Now this action was continued in past for all the time, all evening. Means there wasn't any gap in the evening and that action was continued continuously or consecutively. Now the same way, she was washing utensils all the morning. Now all the morning means the morning when it started till the end of morning she was washing the utensils. Next, we use this tense with still to emphasize the duration. Duration means you are going to tell the duration of time and you will be using still. Like we say, we were still waiting for them. Now here it is telling the duration, that still waiting for them means that action was continuous for, in past. And they were still facing problem. Now still facing problem, that is emphasizing the duration. Hope you got these three. Let's discuss the next ones. Usage number 4. The past indefinite tense and the past continuous tense are used together. The past continuous tense shows a long action. Keep in your mind, we will be using the past indefinite tense and the past continuous tense to show a long action, and in past, the past indefinite tense will be showing a shorter action. Means your past continuous tense action will be a long action and your past indefinite tense action will be a shorter action. In past and used with the following conjunctions. What are the conjunctions? When, just as, while, etc. Now in our coming lectures we will be discussing about clauses. These are actually made by the help of clauses and we will be using here conjunctions. We will discuss what clauses are. That is your adverb clause of time. When we will start, we will discuss what adverb clause of time is. But here we will just understand it as a usage. And what are the conjunctions? Keep in your mind, when, just as, while are the conjunctions of time which will be used to join two clauses to express time. Now example is, when I was teaching the students, the director came. Now see, we are using past continuous tense and we are using past indefinite tense. Here to express that past continuous tense action is longer than the past indefinite tense. Like I say, when I was teaching the students. Now I was teaching the students maybe, you know, half hour before I have started or 1 hour before I have started, the director came. The coming of director may be a moment of 2 minutes, 5 minutes, but the class was continued for an hour before. So this is what we say, that past continuous tense actions will be longer than past indefinite tense. Like another conjunction I've used, just as they were playing, the rain started. Now they were playing, maybe you know one inning has gone and that is what, you know, the second was about to start, or maybe they were in the second inning but the rain started. The starting of rain, you know, that may be for a moment that stopped the playing, but this action was longer than the past indefinite tense. In the same way, as we were attending the paper, the light went off. Now you know you have got 3 hours papers in your, mostly in your competitive exams or anywhere you mostly have the 3 hour papers. Now maybe you have continued it for 1.5 hour, maybe 2 hours, maybe 2.5 hour, but here the light went off. That moment was very short, maybe of 2 seconds, 1 second etc. That what interrupted you all at once. That is known as long action and short action. While you were sleeping, the guest came. Now you were sleeping maybe 2 hours before, 1 hour before, maybe 10 hours before, the guest came. The coming of the guest, just knocking at the door or phoning you people, that is known as a short moment. So you can say that when we compare past continuous tense actions or past indefinite actions, so keep in your mind, past continuous actions will be longer than the past indefinite. Now what is the usage? The past indefinite tense and the past continuous tense are used together. The past continuous tense shows a longer action in past, and the past indefinite tense shows a shorter action in past, and used with the following conjunctions. You will be using conjunctions, and they are completely called clause. You can change their places as well. The rain started just as we were playing. In the same way, you can say the director came when I was teaching the students. You can change the places, you can shuffle them, but we will learn them in classes, because here we are just learning the usages. Hope you got the fourth usage. Let's discuss the fifth one. We use this tense for parallel action. First, try to understand parallel actions. Parallel action means at the same time different activities are going on, like more than one, it can be two or more than three etc. Like I say, we use this tense with for parallel actions to emphasize what do we emphasize here? The fact that, the reality that two or more than two actions were going on or in progress at the same time by using while. And here you will be using subordinating conjunction of time, that is known as while. Now I see at the same time how many actions were going on. While is the word to join conjunctions, like to join two clauses, sentences, clauses or phrases. Now I say, while I was teaching, what more was going on at the same time? Students were learning. So this is what, the same two actions were going on at the same time. While I was teaching, students were learning. Now my action of teaching was also in progress, and students were learning, that was also in progress. There can be some more actions in progress, like I say, while I was teaching, students were learning and they were making noise, means the third party was making noise. Now see, at the same time, by using while, you can use many clauses at the same time, saying that two or more than actions were going on at the same time by using while. Now I say, while I was teaching, students were learning and they were making noise. Director was stopping them and teachers were not happy with them. Now this is what, how many actions were going on? Five. You can bring some more than five, more than five, that depends on you. But here we can say that while I was teaching, students were learning, and while I was teaching, students were learning and they were making noise, etc. Hope you got the usages. Wish you best of luck. Keep practicing. See you next time.